We are going to take up item 4.2, which was approved as an extra item, and this is consideration of agreement with OptumServe mobile vaccination van and team. And I see Director Pomeroy is also with us as well.
Thank you, Chair Sabatier and Supervisors. So the Health Department team here has been working with OptumServe, of course, now for a while on our brick and mortar type of events. We were notified a week ago that the state was no longer going to pay for the vaccine piece of those sites. They would continue to pay for the testing sites, as I had mentioned earlier, on another item. While we've been working with the vaccine team at the state, we had a meeting with them again on Friday. We've been meeting with them a couple days a week, and we had put in a resource request to get a mobile team here. That request was approved late Friday afternoon, and in order to get them here by Monday, we needed to get this approval through with your board. The team, they would be coming in. It's a team of two nurses and a support person. They've got a minivan. We at the health department supply the vaccine to them, so there still will be interaction and oversight from our vaccination team here at the health department. In addition to that, they're scheduled to be here on 8:30. They will do like a dry run day here at the health department, so we can make sure we have everything in alignment for them to start their processes. Then they will be at the fair for Thursday, Friday, Saturday, and Sunday. They'll have a couple of days off, and then there will be mobile schedules set up around the lake. So our intent is that they're in a different district at least one day a week to support the mobile community needs. They can do two different locations in a day, but it's that 8-hour day. They cannot do split shifts, like work 4 hours in the morning and 4 hours at night. But like in Clear Lake, they could be at one side of Clear Lake for 4 hours, take a break for their lunch, move and do another 3 hours at somewhere else. There's a whole scheduling process we have to go through with them, but our request is in order to keep the, to make our vaccination piece go mobile so that we can get the vaccine out into the communities. This request is being brought before your board for review and approval. The cost is just a little over $5,000 a day. They have the capacity to do 100 vaccines a day. We can schedule with them every Monday for the following week. If we want to change a location, we have to give them 72 hours. The total cost that we're asking for right now to start this and get it moving for the next 2 months is $200,000. And we're asking if that can come out of the ARPA funds to support the community COVID-19 vaccination outreach and response. And Dr. Pace may have more to give you on that. I did email you their cost breakdown, which I received late yesterday. So you guys should have that in your email. We have not received the actual agreement yet or the MOU. We're still working with that to get that. And so we're asking your board to give CAO Hutchinson approval to sign that when it comes in.
Thank you very much for the presentation. Any comments or questions from board members? Supervisor Pyska? Supervisor Crandall?
I don't know. I think I didn't see in the vaccinate or the memo, is it Pfizer or Moderna, do we know? Or are we looking at that yet? Or we're just looking at the having this budget?
We're asking for both, but we're really trying to concentrate on Pfizer so we can get the age groups from 12 and above.
And that way you just do the one shot and not have to follow up with the second in case people don't like
that's
take. Okay.
That would be J&J, and there was no mention from them of doing J&J.
Okay. And so I'm just wondering only because we're going to have to schedule those second vaccinations. Just want to make sure that they don't get done one time and then nothing happens, if that makes sense. But I'm just asking, that's all.
No, follow through is important, so I appreciate the question. Supervisor Pyska?
And that's why we're asking for 2 months, Supervisor, is because we want to make sure those second injections happen back at the same location where they received the first one.
Thank you, Denise.
You're welcome.
My question is about, so you'll be doing vaccines and testing simultaneously on the same days, or is it going to be set up for different services for different days?
Right now, we're still working out those logistics, and so those details have not been finalized, but the thought is that we would be rotating, and vaccine would be at that site one day and then testing a different day. They're very separate teams. They're not the same teams. So we have to make sure they have enough space, you know, bathrooms, all their supplies that they could do to do it mobily.
Any further
questions? I don't know if Carolyn is on here or not, but Carolyn and Emily have been working, and myself have been working with this team. But Carolyn and Emily are really trying to work out, and Dean are working out the logistics of this.
And I do not see them here. But we do have a question from Supervisor Siteman, or a comment.
Just want to clarify, you know, obviously understand that it's coming from the American Rescue Plan funds, and this is an allowed expense, correct, Carol? This is exactly what these funds can be used for. I just want to clarify that for everybody. This is exactly what some of the ARPA funds are to be used for, to bring and help enhance the opportunity for testing vaccinations into the communities that need it the most. And some of the folks, you know, we've talked about traveling, transportation issues and others, and this is just one more step in that opportunity.
That's correct.
I know I could answer my own question, but I wanted to clarify that you know, this was, you know, not a request out of ordinary. This is exactly what these funds are to be used for. Secondly, I guess the question would be to you, Denise, obviously talking about communication. We know that folks, every time we have an update, we are constantly talking about the opportunities where they can get vaccinated or get tested. And just want to make sure that we have a very good communication opportunity out to our communities, both on any county websites and other areas. And I am much appreciative of the conversation happening. And like we said, so it'll be hitting every district throughout the week, from my understanding and what we're talking about today. And I think that is what we need to do to bring these to the people. So thank you. And I guess my question is, do you have a communication plan to get that out to everybody?
We are working with Matthew and the three agencies that we've contracted with, preliminary to get a communication plan out as soon as the logistics are nailed down.
Thank you.
Any further comments? So I do have a slight hesitance for this item here. $200,000, it seems to me that because you pay people for the day's worth of work, but for example, they may have just done one vaccine. I'd like to have a way to obtain the data of how much are we actually getting out of this? Because if we're spending $200,000 and only 10 people got vaccinated, it's just not worth it. And I know that that's probably not going to be the case, but we have opportunities in our community to get vaccinated. I want to make sure that we have other opportunities, but I also want to make sure that we're not just spending money on something that's going to cost us $200,000 for just a very meager amount of vaccines, when maybe we could have done that in a different way to get those vaccines to the people. What is the Is there any checkpoints during this 2 month period? Because again, it's an expensive amount for just 2 months worth of work. Yes, if we could do 100 vaccines a day, I think that's absolutely worth it. But if it's going to be 5 to 10 a day, I don't know that that's actually worth it versus working specifically to try and get to those 5 or 10 people. I don't know. I'm concerned. We have the money. But just because we have money doesn't mean we have to spend it unless we actually get something in return. So kind of curious if there's any checkpoints where we might be able to check in, look at the data, and see if we want to continue versus boom, we're done, we spent 200 grand.
So we have we already have a weekly meeting scheduled with Optum that we've been doing throughout the response. That meeting will continue, and that is the exact purpose of that meeting, is to make sure that their needs are being met, but also it's serving, continues to serve the purpose of the intent of the board.
Okay, and in those meetings, because you say you want them here by Monday, is there a plan of where they're supposed to be to start the vaccination, or is that when the outreach and the plan to go out starts? Because it just feels like it's very short notice, and I'm not aware at this moment in time of any plans to for a mobile unit to go around. That's kind of similar to the question that Supervisor Simon had about the communication, but I just want to make sure again that we don't have a week's lag of time where there's minimal activities because nobody knows about it or is not as aware about it. Again, it's just I'm looking at the number for the short amount of time and just a little concerned.
So Mondays, we have a clinic here at the health department, and they will be coming in to do that clinic here at the health department, which will allow us to make sure we have everything in line for the fair. Then Thursday, Friday, Saturday, and Sunday, they will be the main vaccinators at the fair site. And then that gives us the beginning of next week to get the message out for the rotation of the mobile van the next week following.
Okay. And then Dr. Pace, you spoke about farm worker vaccine program or something along those lines. Sorry for not using the right terms. Is that something that this would be utilized with?
Well, this is the farm worker program you're talking about is this week. So it's okay. This Thursday. We've already got that set up. So this predates that this mobile site coming in. But it's certainly something that could be part of the plan in the future. I think I think really from my point of view, partly what we're talking about here is trying to really activate the demand in the county and trying to get people vaccinated now before the winter. And in this way, by getting a very robust program and getting it moving around the county more, we are going to have the capacity to vaccinate people. Now it's going to be up to us and all of our partners to really generate interest in folks that are unvaccinated to try to take the next step and to try to get, because if we could get, we've got something a little over 50% of the eligible people vaccinated now. If we could get that up to 70 or 75% by winter, we would be in a lot better shape in terms of protecting the capacity of the hospitals, preventing severe illness and death if and when the next surge comes. So I think the thinking here is to really try to get something really solid in place so that we can really start trying to encourage people on a more robust level to get moving forward with this, especially the schools.
And at this moment in time, you said that the agreement is being worked on. If we approve today, we approve for the conversation for the agreement to begin, or we approve and you sign the agreement and it gets started? Because I am also a little concerned that I don't see the agreement in front of us, and spending $200,000 without an actual agreement, which is basically a contract, I'm slightly uncomfortable.
I haven't seen it yet. I did get the cost proposal, and we have asked for, and I'm not sure, Supervisor or Chair, if it's an agreement or an MOU, or if it's just a resource that the state has allocated that that we're gonna be responsible for paying for. So we're still working with them on some of the logistics.
Okay, and I believe CAO Hutchinson had something to say. You unmuted. If you can mute your Zoom.
It's unmuted, but okay. So I was going to suggest that the hope is that this service would start on Monday, but you do have a special board meeting on Tuesday. What if this service started after Tuesday? and then we could bring the agreement to your board on Tuesday so you can look over the agreement, because it is a considerable amount of money. It's certainly a service that I think we want to offer, and I believe I was told that it has the potential capacity for up to 100 shots a day. If it could operate at that level, it probably would be cost effective. That would certainly be the hope over the 40-day period that it would be in the county. But if we delayed this by just a couple of days, then it would give your board the opportunity to see the actual agreement.
Ms. Grant?
From a legal perspective, that would be wise, because a delegation...
Microphone, please. I don't know if you're not speaking into it or...
Hello?
We killed your microphone.
From a legal perspective, that would be wise, because the delegation should not be vague or generalized. It does need to be specific. Your board can delegate your authority in more of a ministerial capacity than a discretionary one. So it's always better to have the parameters of whatever authority you're delegating very clearly spelled out.
And if you act in that way, then today you would be giving conceptual approval to use the ARPA funds, but then you could approve the contract on Tuesday and have the service start shortly thereafter.
Okay, I thank you for that. Any comments from that?
My only comment was to make sure that we would still be able to be at the fair, because that is going to be a big event with many people will be able to get vaccinated. So I don't want to delay it and not be able to have this mobile van at the fair.
Any other comments from board members? Okay, let's go ahead and open it up to the public. Anyone have any questions or comments about this item? Seeing none in the Zoom room and seeing none in the boardroom, let's go ahead and bring it back to the board. I personally feel more comfortable, but I also want to ask Director Pomeroy and Dr. Pace, what is the possibility of what was offered to start as of Tuesday? Does that cancel every possibility of them coming here? I'd like to know what the repercussions of our potential actions, what they could be.
So what we would probably, what we'd ask them to do is start on Wednesday. They have to have 2 days off in a row and with a 5-day work week. So the thought was they would come Monday, get the lay of the land, look at the fairgrounds, provide vaccine here at the health department, have Tuesday, Wednesday off, and then work 4 days for the fair. But we can ask them to just come on Wednesday and do the same thing that they would have done on Monday on Wednesday.
And is anything signed for them to be here on Monday? Because
no.
I wouldn't mind spending ARPA funds to pay them for the day to at least come and see the lay of the land and to set up for this, because at that point that would not be an arm and a leg. And then review the agreement and then move forward with either the agreement or whatever it is that we decide to do. What do you think that would be possible? That way there's not a delay in their process? Because I agree with Supervisor Scott, but also I don't want to put ourselves in a situation that is not necessarily the exact position that we want to be in.
There's nothing been signed. That's way above my authority, so that's why it's here before your board as an extra item. And I think in working with them over the last several weeks, they are going to prefer doing the Wednesday through Sunday.
Okay.
They really like the 5 days in a row with 2 days off. So I can reach out to them and check and try to get back to your board before your board closes today, if you would prefer that. Otherwise, I would take Carol's recommendation and move forward with it starting here in Lake County on Wednesday and being at the fair Thursday through Sunday.
CIO Hutchinson?
Yeah, I just wanted to pose a slight alternative to my earlier recommendation, and that would be, as you know, a department head or myself have authority to approve up to $25,000 worth of service without coming to your board. And so what I would recommend in order to get them here and get started is that Denise or myself could approve a couple of days, and then you can see the agreement for the longer haul on Tuesday, the 31st. And make your decision about long term. How would that be?
And that somewhat parallels my thought for the Monday knowing that it would only cost a certain amount. I know we have it on a day-to-day basis what it would cost, so yes, I would agree to that.
Yes.
It looks like everyone else is agreeing to that. I do have one final question. Will the agreement be ready to go on Tuesday? Because I know sometimes there's some back and forth, and it doesn't always happen in a snap of a finger. Just making sure that there's enough time to be able to come back to the board on Tuesday with a final MOU or a final agreement.
I will make it happen as long as they get it to us. I mean, that's, you know, and we're hoping to have it today, but I don't know. I haven't heard from them yet this morning.
Okay. All right. Any further questions from the board? No. Let's go ahead and reopen it up. Just I don't even know if I opened it up for the public. Again, come to the microphone if you have any questions or comments.
John Moss, I'm sorry to be the one to always ask questions, but I'd like to know if people coming into the fair will get free tickets into the fair if they get a vaccine?
I believe that is a different agenda item that will be coming up.
Oh, you're not going to answer that question? I mean, this
we,
is
we, what... We can discuss it at that agenda item that is on our agenda today.
I thought that was what we were discussing. No?
Not right now. Right now we're discussing a contract with OptumServe for a mobile van unit to do vaccines.
I think there should be a mobile van offering COVID tests also. Thank you.
Thank you very much. Any further comments or questions? And let's bring it back. I believe we have consensus on how to move forward. I don't think there's a need for a motion at this time. Looking at Ms. Grant, who's shaking her head no. All right, thank you so much. And thank you again to the public health team.
Thank you.